Hello you beautiful peeps, my name's John, welcome to my channel. Today we have the Hobbywing Program Card. As you can see, I'm not going to be showing you how to use it today, because that's in another video. What I am going to be doing is answering a question that has been asked of me several times. Can you use this on other brands? Manufacturers, obviously. So we've got like the XLF, what's this, Zeddy Racing, JLB, underneath there is Isshin, which is a WL Tour, anyway, moving on. So I thought what I could do is get as many ESCs together as I can and test to see if it'll actually work. Obviously, I'll show you roughly how it works as well. The one issue that I have is obviously some manufacturers, I don't know what the ESCs are that are in them. Some of them have not got names on them. Some of you may know better than me. Please do not attack me in the comments for not knowing what type of ESC is in all of these cars. I have a lot of them, I can't remember everything. So I think what we should do, it's going to be quite difficult to get them all into shot, so I'm just going to try my best, okay? Zeddy Racing BX8E. Ah, no. Everything's in there. All right, let's bring this over and crush some things. Let's get in. Come on. There we go. So the what you need to do is get the cable from the ESC, like so. And in most cases, why is that so bright? There we go, sorry about that. In most cases, you have the slit there. And as you can see on the top of this, there is a slit there. It goes on the right-hand side from what I can figure out. Seems to work that way, so we'll go like that. I need some power, so I'm just going to use a 2S battery that I had laying around. Hopefully it's got some power in it. I don't know if there's any danger of this driving off by itself, but if it is, it'll be funny. Right. We have takeoff. Does not seem to be working. So, I believe, I'm pretty sure it goes in that one. I really should have tested this before, shouldn't I? Right. It does not work with the BX8E, my favorite car. Right, done. I'll tidy all of these up later. You go there. And we have the waterproof ESC 120 amp 2-4S LiPo. Can't remember what brand this is. I believe this is a Surpass Hobby. Hopefully, usually they've got their name all over it. Anyway, this isn't the one that obviously came with the 104001. I should have checked, was it? Yeah. Like so, have some power. No, we have no power. Does anybody know if you can take it from there to there, why it's turned on? Should we find out? I'm gonna just try it the other way around in case I've got this wrong. No. Ooh. Nope. Okay, does not work with this one. I am 99% sure that this is the Surpass Hobby one. No, it's not. Where have I nicked that from? Well, if you can identify this one, please let me know in the comments below. That is number 2. I don't know. Right. Isshin EAT 14. That's not going to get frustrating, is it? Right. I should probably unplug it first. There we go. Plug it in the top. Turn it on. We have nothing. So it turns out you can't use it on a lot of cars, but it obviously saves you guys buying it and finding that out when you get it to your house. Excellent. Bye bye. Let's check this one. Ooh, that's tiny. This has got the ESC and receiver in one, so that simply will not work. No, I don't think it will work. Please let me know in the comments below if it does work, if I just don't know what I'm talking about concerning that one there, I'm afraid. This is the JLB Cheetah, and we have the... Two to four S lipo. I think it's an 80 amp. 80, yes, okay. Let's get it out. Which one? There we go, just take them all out. Why not? Stick it in the top, like so. Power. Not working with any of them. I expected it to work with a few more than this, to be honest with you. I'll put that together afterwards. Ooh. Yes, I'm running out of space. Someone did say that it works with LC Racing. Do not know. We will find out. No. Actually, need to take it from the ESC, which is this one. Let's have a look. Power. Oh, that's going to turn on. Sorry about that. Actually, no. No, no. Yay! Why did that not turn on? Oh, like I'm mad. Anyway, right, so here we go. Let me bring you down. Off and on again. As you can see, we have item number one, which is running mode. So it's set at currently number two, which is forward, reverse, with brake. So all of these settings you can pretty much change. You can read them there for yourself. If I move to number two, is this set on number eight, which is drag, brake, force. Three, it is number four, which is three cell for the cutoff threshold. So basically, let me pick out a couple here. Start mode, punch. Now, I hope I'm not wrong, but I believe this is how quickly it accelerates away. So you accelerate and it either goes like full or, you know, a bit slow or whatever. The same for brake force is like you brake and it will only do it in 50%, 100, whatever, whatever. So keep that in mind. There are lots of settings, as you can see, that you can change here. So it's definitely worthwhile if you've got an ESC that's separate from a receiver to buy one of these. I believe this one cost $10 US. But not if you own one of the other cars that it doesn't work on, obviously. So, oh man, so many cars, so many lives. Great. 45 minutes afterwards, putting all these cars back together and in their position. Here we go. This is the WL Toys 0124017. Let's see, shall we? Power on. No. Okay. This tiny little card here. Sorry about that. Tiny little card here. Let's turn that off. Exactly the same thing happens with it. You plug it in like so, white to white. This one does work. So you can see I've already got it set to strong to try and solve the cogging issue. You just go down and set it to which one you want. And these are even cheaper, these are like $4 US, but they don't have as many settings on them, obviously. So keep that in mind. Put that one there for now. What have we got? This is again the WL Toys. Oops. This has actually got my Surpass Hobby 3650 in here with the 60 amp ESC, but again, it'll be interesting to know if it works. No, Surpass Hobby, it doesn't seem to want to work with at all, does it? There's the one off switch, there we go. So do I have any others? So the only one that it's actually worked with so far is the LC Racing. That's a real surprise. A real, real surprise. What else have we got? It's got to be one that I can actually get to. What do you think about that one? Should I get that one down? It's very big. Yes, it's got small wheels on it at the minute. It's because I nicked them off this one to put onto the ZD Racing for another video. But then the bad weather came. Oh, so dirty. What a shame. I'm pretty sure it's similar electronics to on the BX8E, but let's have a look. Get in. Nice. I believe that this is the accelerator. Yes, see. Oh, how do I do this? Not gonna. This is what I was thinking of doing. Twisting the cables around so that I could slide it on like that. I'm not going to attempt to do that because I don't want to blow up my ESC on this one. I have a really, really big project with this one that I've been trying to find time to do, and I don't want to risk blowing that one up. So what else have I got that has a separate ESC? Right, okay, well, one so far, the LC Racing seems to the Hobbywing to actually work on. I'm pretty sure I had one more to test, but obviously I don't. So do not buy this one if you have any of the other cars that I've obviously tested. Get yourself just a basic one of these, or actually one for the manufacturer of the one that you have. I was hoping that it was going to be a more of a universal card, one that worked on a lot of different brands, but as you see, it just doesn't. So if you have any of the others, do not buy this one. If you have a Hobbywing, definitely buy one of these. I mean, they're pretty handy, definitely. So, but as I said, I'll go into more details on that on another video. So take care of yourself, stay safe. Bye-bye.